What's happening, guys? Eric with the Hot Box Pizza Truck. We're gonna follow this dough along and talk about dough management in a wood fire pizza truck. And the reason being, or a trailer or a mobile operation, is I had somebody reach out to me and say, is there any way you could explain, you know, more or less your process, your management, because a lot of people talk about it, but not in a mobile setting. And why it's so different in a mobile setting is because we have such crazy temperature swings. Just getting the oven ready. Like right now, it's nice in here. You know, the temperature is not too bad. But later this afternoon, we'll be 95 degrees in here. And it's between the temperature and the humidity, it definitely affects the dough. So there's a couple things. You guys have seen me make my dough before. If you want to check out videos, there's got several of those up. But this is a batch of 25 dough balls. And I try to use containers. First, I only do batches of 25 at the most, because it fits these containers perfect. And when they rise, it's right where I want it to be. And they go in the refrigerator really well. And I can tweak batches here and there to look for different results. And also, if you're doing an event, you can space out the times you make dough, you know, by 30 minutes an hour, let them rise a little bit different rate. So that way you use, you know, your first batch, second batch, and third batch. And hopefully your third batch is the batch you made last and you had a slower rise. So, you know, as you're doing the event and the dough's rising in the trays, it's going to be you know, you have more consistent dough throughout the day rather than one big batch where your balls in the morning are going to be tighter and then, say, your balls in the afternoon are going to be blown out. So it's, you know, reason why I go with these. Now, on this batch of 25, I put it in. I just give it a little pat down so it's nice and level. And it's at the 5 here. During the winter time, spring, fall, I'll let it rise. It'll sit on the counter, and usually about an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours, it'll rise to that blue mark. From there, I go in the refrigerator with it. Summertime, I always, right now I'm about a half an hour behind on making my dough. I usually do it right around 10 o'clock. So summertime, I may leave it out for 10 minutes, may go out for 20 minutes, may not go out at all. It just depends on how hot it is in the truck, where the refrigeration's at, what the dough looks like when I make it. It's you're constantly forecasting, guessing, and tweaking each day to try to get it to where you want it to be. But this batch of 25, what I'm going to do is I just made it, you know, again, I like to make it around 10 o'clock. I'm going to only let it sit out for about 15, 20 minutes, and then it's going to go in the refrigerator because of how hot it is today. It's going to be, you know, feels like are over, heat index is over 100 degrees today. So as this rises, let's look at it one more time. As this rises, this is going to start to become like a half a basketball. It's going to raise up in a big dome, and it's going to get hard. It's going to get a hard crust on it. Once it starts to get to a certain point, the gases and the bubbles are going to break through that skin and start to soften that skin up. And as soon as that skin is soft, it's nice, that's where I like to go. That's when I like to go ahead and roll it. And I usually roll in the evenings around 6, 6:30, something like that. Depends on how busy I am. You know, I squeeze in a tray here and there between customers. But if I'm slammed, it'll be 7 o'clock. But this is a 24-hour dough, and I'm making it for use for tomorrow at 11:30 when I open. So, like I say, this is gonna rise. Once that skin breaks and the bubbles are coming through and it softens up, that's exactly where I wanna roll it. If you let it go too far, and when that's to that point, I'm just starting to touch the lid here. So, you know, these are perfect size for this. So try to get a decent size bucket with or close to wherever your dough is going to be maxed out at. If I let it go too long, it can blow the lid off, or it can hit the lid and
What I don't like is when your dough gets to a certain point, when it rises to a certain point, then it starts collapsing. Once all those gas bubbles and everything soften up the top, then it'll start collapsing. If you let it go too long, it's going to collapse down, and then you're going to get another hard skin over it. So that's overproofed for me. This is where I like my dough. I hope you guys are following and I'm not giving you too much information. So once this is risen, I'm going to pull this out later and show you guys where it's at. I'll ball it up and it goes directly back in the refrigerator, and all my dough is always refrigerated year round because of my temperature swings in here. When I'm making dough, if it's a rainy day, I'll drop down on the moisture a little bit. Right now it's wet out, and if you don't think humidity makes a difference in the dough, you don't know. We'll just leave it at that. So I'll come back later on this afternoon, show you guys where this is at and how it's coming along. And this is just kind of the way I manage my dough. I try to do everything super easy. I'm by myself. I used to do a 2-day dough, but then you 2 days before you have to go back to work, you're in here making dough. So the sacrifice was not enough. So I just went ahead and I'm at a 24-hour dough. Everything's refrigerated. In the wintertime when it's really cold, I may have to let this thing sit out for 4 or 5 hours before it goes in the refrigerator. It just depends. And that's just doing it all the time. You get to realize how fast it rises with the heat or the cold, the temperature. And so you're always making adjustments throughout the day. And if you're doing it all the time, you kind of know how fast it's going to rise. And it can catch you off guard sometimes. But so I'm going to go ahead and bring you guys back in a little bit. And we'll follow this dough all the way till tomorrow. I'll show you when I pull it out later, roll it. I'll show you what it looks like in the morning. And then I'll show you what it looks like on our first or second pizza. All right, guys. All right, guys. I just wanted to do a quick check. We're not ready yet. I'm still a couple hours from rolling, so we're right on schedule here. But you can see there's like a hard crust, and then you can see where the bubbles are starting to break through. And this is, I don't know if you can see how it's domed, but it's coming up. We started there. We're here now. Or there, you can see it. Let me back up. So we went from 5. Now we're up about here. So we're getting close. This thing will come up, the whole top will soften, and that's when I want to roll it before it starts to collapse down. So lid back on, and a couple more hours, it should be right where we want it to be. All right, guys, let's pull this dough out and see where it's at. 5:45. Didn't go much more in the last hour and a half. It actually could go a little bit more, and I've got some mortars coming up. But it's almost all soft. You can see the big area starting to break up and soften it up. So it's actually a little, it's not quite as high as I would like, but again, I was about a half an hour late on making my dough today. So really, in about 45 minutes, it'd probably be pretty close to where I want it. I like it a little bit higher, but I know tomorrow's gonna be very, very warm, so we're gonna be okay with it. It's all a guessing game, forecasting. You're just trying to make educated guess on what you're doing every day and what the temperatures are. So we're close, not quite there, but we're probably gonna have to go with it. So we'll see in a few. All right, guys, so here's my dough. It's not quite as risen as I would like it to be. Again, I was about 30 minutes behind, so I'm about 30 minutes behind right now. But I'm gonna go ahead and roll it because I'd rather be a little underproof than overproof, because you'd rather start your day off in the morning where you can pull your dough balls out and let them come up a little bit, rather than starting your day where they're already blown out and you got nowhere to go but your dough just getting worse and worse throughout the day. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this out and I'm gonna be rolling it. This has gotten soft. It's not hard. It's not where I want it to be. Everything out.
everything is incorporated. Give it a good smack. And I'm just gonna cut one dough ball and roll it for you guys. Dough feels good. So we got a customer here. Let me just go ahead and roll this real quick and show you guys. So I had a couple customers and had to throw the dough back in. So now it's back out. The way I do it is I go ahead and I just cut a tray at a time of dough balls and then roll those since I'm by myself. Because in the summertime, it's so hot that they'll start to take off on you and get sticky and ferment quick. And in the wintertime, they start to dry out when they're sitting here. So I only cut a tray at a time. I'll go ahead and roll these. And then in the refrigerator, and that's it until tomorrow. So just when you're cutting the dough and getting them to this point and then rolling them, you can actually tell if it's too cold, if they're too tight, you know, just by the feel of the temperature and how soft they are, you kind of know if you're going to be good to go for tomorrow. And we're feeling and looking perfect for tomorrow. So I'm going to get these rolled up and we'll continue these videos on tomorrow to show you where the dough's at. These beauties we just rolled. Another reason why I also do one tray at a time is if you do get customers, you can throw them in the tray real quick, put it in the fridge, and then when you're done, pull the tray back out and roll them and not have a ton of dough balls all over the place. So these guys are going in at 6:30. They're going in the fridge now. And they're gonna marinate, hang out, relax, continue to do their thing. And this will be our dough that we start using at 11:30 when we open up tomorrow. So we'll take a look. They're going in. Good night. We'll see you in the morning. All right, guys. It's day two of our dough. So we made it yesterday. And we're using it today. And as you can see, it's looking really nice. These are 7.5 ounce 10 inch balls. This is one 10 ounce 12 inch ball. Get it out real quick. You can see it's just starting to get a bubble. I want to start my day where my dough's not all blown out. See, I want to start my day like this, not where it's got huge bubbles. It's, you know what I'm talking about, guys. You're messing with dough. But at the end of the day, chances are it will be. Chances are at the end of the day, it will be kind of blown out. So you're just kind of trying to get usable dough all day without having to fight it. You don't want to start your day with the dough all blown out like that, and all day long you're chasing it, trying to get some color out of it, just getting super soft and real hard to use. But you can see this, it feels wonderful right now. I come straight out of the refrigerator with it. And if you're doing events, you know, whatever size batches you do, 25, 50, 75, 100, just make sure that your bucket's not too big. Like I was explaining earlier, keep an eye on how fast they're rising and pay attention. Make your adjustments each day and get it where you want it to be. You're pretty much just, you're forecasting what's gonna go down. You're guessing, educated guess on, look at that, that was beautiful. Just educated guess on doing it every day. You know, you wanna make small changes. Don't make huge changes. Pay attention when your dough is not where you want it. go through and, you know, go over your steps of how it got there and see where you want to change it. We're doing a pepperoni, sausage, onion, and mushroom. But yeah, you want a nice usable dough. That dough is going to continue to rise all day, and by the end of the day, it's going to be about at the end of the point, or, you know, about as much as I want to push it, or as much as I like it. And when you're doing, you know, multiple batches for events, maybe space them out when you're making them, so that way you have, went a little heavy there, but he's a good customer. Multiple batches, so that way they're rising at different times and you're using them at different times. And your different size batches will also rise differently. So your refrigerator has different hot and cold spots in it. Different refrigerators will do your dough differently. I've got two different refrigerators I use, and each one the dough rises differently in it. So these are all things you can't get overwhelmed with when you're first starting out, because a lot of this stuff just starts coming naturally. And it's just a progression of working with the dough every day that you start to figure this stuff out. So don't get yourself overwhelmed. There's a lot of people that, you know, scream, there's only one way to do it. This is how you should do something. You know, they'll tell you you're wrong. There's a lot of different ways to go about this. Whatever works for you. Some people may not like their dough, or I like my dough. It's all personal preference. But this is the way I've been doing it. I like a little color on my pizza. I like a little bit of a crisp, but it's still a very soft dough. Someone asked how I know, you know, when to add or take away. Oh, I'm sorry, hydration on the pizza. Well, when you come in the morning and the truck is soaking wet on the outside, the windows have got water dripping off of them, condensation, because it's so humid out. When, you know, in the wintertime, when your skin's dry, you can add water to the dough, you know, just, you'll know. When it's raining all day, there's a lot of moisture in the air. It changes your dough. In the front of the tray rises a little bit faster than the dough in the back of the tray. That's, you know, where the further into the refrigerator. All these little things make a difference, and you can use all these to your advantage. You just pay attention, take notes on what you're doing, and you know, don't just say, oh, my dough's off today, and not try to figure out why it's off. Make your changes a little bit at a time, and manage your dough. As you guys saw, for me, pretty much in the summertime, except for about 15 or 20 minutes. Except for about 15 or 20 minutes yesterday, my dough is all refrigeration. It's already 85 degrees here in the truck. It's only going to get hotter. Stuff like overcast skies, rain, that all affects the temperature in the truck. You're, you know, 10 degrees in the truck, 4 or 5 degrees in the oven. All this stuff adds up every day and makes a difference on your dough. Get it up a little bit here for a minute. The base is plenty hot. If you want a bigger crust on them, don't stretch. we're back on. Let's give it a quick cut. Goes right through.
Actually stretch this a little bit further. Made that crust a little small on this one. But it's a beautiful looking pizza. That dough is wonderful. And I'll do another pizza later in the afternoon to show you where it's at. But it felt great. Cooked the way I wanted. And it's all about repetition. I'll bring you guys back here in a little bit. Do another one in this afternoon. All right, we're about halfway through the day. You can see the dough is still looking wonderful. Let's do a quick pizza reel.
A quick pizza real quick.
Let's do a pizza real fast. In your hands while it's slowly stretching. Just gets easier as the day goes on and the dough loosens up. If you got a bunch of orders going on, pull your dough out and just let it sit, and it just helps to loosen it up and get the party started. Go with the Hawaiian fire. This will probably end up by being about a 20-minute video, I think, by the time it's all said and done. But I just want to show you guys a couple pizzas throughout the day, because that's the key to the success, is to have dough that'll last you throughout your, whether it be 4 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours, your event, your regular day, whatever. A little heavy on the chicken because I want to use it up, because I just made a bunch of fresh chicken. This is my pizza for lunch and my wife's. But when you go heavy like that and it's not fully stretched yet, you're actually not too bad, because once you stretch it spreads everything out a little bit more. Banana peppers and jalapenos. Could have probably went with a little bit more jalapenos on it. But once you get all your other ingredients, it should be just about right. Toughest part about me doing these videos is having to turn the music down. One of my favorite things is just to have the radio up all day and just enjoy working. Get yourself in the groove, get yourself in the mindset. The stuff off the edge helps the crust to rise.
top of the oven there.
For time, I'm gonna go ahead and shut it off and I'll bring you back when I'm done with this one.
See, check that out. I didn't go as push out the crust as much and put the ingredients to the edge as much.
So I got a lot bigger area edge than I did on that last one that I showed you guys.
Let me get a box here. Big crust,
crispy on the outside, hear it? Let's check underneath.
Beautiful.
Results like this. It's not rocket science, it's just constant working with it and getting a feel for it. That's why I don't get scientific. I don't want to get into the weeds with it. The more time you spend with it, it just all starts to click and come together for you guys. Anybody can do it.
All right, we're gonna do one more pizza later tonight.
So we've got three pies, one in the morning, one in the middle of the afternoon, and one in the evening.
Just 93 degrees, the rain just started.
Let's see how fast it cools down and how much.
Degrees in about 30 minutes. Makes a difference.
End of the day dough. We nailed it. So you got your bubble here, but we made it. Made it till the end of the day before we started getting big bubbles. They're underneath. But that's a win for today. I'll do one more pizza with it here in a few minutes to show you guys, and that's a wrap.
All right, guys, last pizza of the day. Hopefully. When you take it out of the
box, it's just so light right now, it starts to want to fall on itself.
So we made it, we made it, we made it, we made it. Nice dough all day. You can see you can really get it done fast when it gets real soft like this. And you gotta watch not to overstretch your dough. You gotta watch not to overstretch your dough when it's super soft like this, because it'll go fast for you. Whoa, come on, Ben. 12-inch pie, pizza. This will end up by being a long video because I've added so much, you know, just kept bringing you along to show you throughout the day. But again, there's many ways you can do things. You know, I'm not
an up north truck, so I don't know what you guys deal with in the winter. I'm sure you need to use some proofing things. You know, there's the cold refrigerator method isn't going to work for you. But this is just to show you the summertime heat, how to kind of try to tame the beast. Again, I'm not trying to get into scientific stuff because that's not how I learned. I just learned by dealing with it all day, every day, and making my changes as I go.
So who knows how this is going to come out, but I'm putting it up because I think I gave you guys a lot of little tips. You know, even if you just get one thing out of it, so be it. That was a success. Bring you right back.
But a few things to look for when you're doing it. You know, how fast it's rising when you got it sitting on the bench. And then just getting an understanding of when you go in the refrigerator until you're ready to roll the dough, is it gonna be where you want it to be? Which again, I talked about that bubble coming up, the dough coming up and rising. I'm doing this one hand, let's hope we don't rip it. The dough rising and the gas bubble starting to come through and break up that skin before it gets too much and then starts to go back down on itself. Just rolling it at the right time. Big thing too is make sure, yeah, we gotta hop on it. Let me set this down.
Super hot right now. Woo!
Finish this up real quick.
I lost track of what I was talking about now. But anyhow.
Oh, I was gonna say, when you roll it, make sure you're rolling it at a decent time in the afternoon.
You know, like, don't be rolling at 8, 9 o'clock at night and then want to use it for your event at 11, 11:30, 12 o'clock, because it's going to be hard as heck to stretch. So try to let it sit for a while and relax. I like to always get mine done before 7 o'clock. If I'm doing it after that, which is fine, it's going to be for my pizzas, you know, during an event in the evening. So as you can see, beautiful crust. Beautiful margarita, great dough all day. Oh man, that looks gorgeous. I like color on my pizza, so this is a win for me. And just pay attention and make small adjustments and you guys will get it. Don't get anxiety about, you know, not knowing dough if you're starting an operation. As soon as you start working with it every day, it's gonna come to you. It's gotta come to you. But I hope you guys enjoyed this. I'm gonna get it all uploaded tonight, and we'll talk to you guys soon. God bless you guys. Thanks.